Russia authority on changing the name of Hari. From his youth, very youth, young age, he was attracted to the chanting of the holy name. Even he was born in a Muslim family, he was partly not accepted by the Hindu society. Chanting of the holy name, he was the Namacharya. Mahaprabhu, he made him the Namacharya because he was constantly chanting the name. He was chanting 3 lakhs a day, his whole life. 3 lakhs means 300,000 names. It means 64 hours it's 1 lakh. So it's 3 times 64 rounds, not. Constantly he kept his whole life. He was chanting the name. And Mahaprabhu, he was calling him. And say, Haridas, your chanting is so powerful. Because it purifies the whole universe. Can you imagine? We cannot even purify this between our ears. How powerful his chanting was. How sincere Haridas Thakur was. Because he understood perfectly this material world where we are now here, it is an illusion, it has nothing to do with reality. So if we change like Haridas Thakur, we have to realize, we have to understand first. This is a temporary life. Temporary means whatever we can measure by distance, by so many ways. Whatever is measurable has nothing to do with reality. So we cannot measure the world because there is no beginning and no end. We cannot, but we can measure everything in this material world. It is a beginning and an end. So he realized this from the very beginning. So chanting was very powerful and he could identify what is real, what is reality, this illusion or maya. So he is chanting Mahaprabhu saying that you are purifying the whole universe with your chanting. We have to realize what kind of person he was. How is it possible that one person can purify the whole universe? What means purified? Freeing from illusion. Make him free, make him understand, hey, you are not members of this world. We are members of the world, what is beyond material conception of what we call reality here. You can see this world or this life is just like a horrible place, because constantly we meet birth, death, old age, disease, especially nowadays. Everybody gets lost, even everybody doesn't, nobody does care for this. Yes, we are everybody in future, it will be better. But it will not be better, we will get older. We will face reality. What is reality? Birth, disease, old age, and death. This is reality in this material world. Has any argument against this? Anything we have experienced? No, it is not like this. So we are not able to take anything from this world to the next, where we are going to, according to our activities. So this has been realized fully by those kind of devotees who came here in who are not ordinary devotees, ordinary beings. They are coming from the world beyond the material world. They're coming from the world where there's no birth, no old age, no disease, no death. So they are not speculating. It is not a belief to them. I believe in the heaven. I believe in God exists. God does not exist. It is not a subject of this kind of speculation. Because if we have no realization, no understanding what is beyond our so-called real life or material life, then we will always be prisoners. We are living in a world that has definitely not a happy end. For those who want to die because of realizing that it's very tough here, but even for them, they do not know where to go. So Haridas, he has realized to the highest degree. He constantly remembers. He saw the necessary to constantly remember the Supreme Lord. He exists everywhere. He transforms for him, the whole material world into the spiritual world, because he could see the Lord everywhere. There was no material world he was living in. And that's because Mahaprabhu liked him very much. He always was connected with the Supreme Lord. He protected him from so many things, so many. Maya personally came to make him fall down. Two times. Second time, Maya personally was there. But then she realized he is not a member of this material world. So Maya surrendered to Haridas. She became disciple of Haridas. It was the goddess Maya Durga, Kaliya, as you want to name her. So she became disciple of Haridas. He was a glorious person. So when I speak in Puri 20 years ago, I stayed very near to this samadhi. On the roof of the building, I could see the samadhi and the properties were being there. And I was trying to pray and to get the mercy of Haridas. So for months I was every day chanting my Rama in the morning up to the roof and was looking and begging Haridas to be pleased. That's me. So that I can understand your reality and the illusion, the difference. No, unless we have no particular experience of the reality, we will also not believe, we will give it up, this so-called mundane reality. We have to realize, we have to pray with those devotees who have seen the truth. We have to that we be Pali Bhatina, Pali Prasnena, Sivaya, Upade Exalmiti Gyana, Gyanina Stattvatakshin. If you want to know the truth, if you want to really know the truth, you have to approach a bona fide spiritual master. What to do? You have to serve him. You have to ask questions in a humble state of mind, not challenging, not out of enviousness, finding fault. You are lost in this material world, you are alone, and we are approaching in a different way. And Maya did not let us go. Why we should do this? Because he is the one who has seen the truth. He has seen the truth and he can give you the truth as it is. Never nothing that we can go there, we can understand the transcendental land of Radha and Krishna without the help of bona fide spiritual master. It is not possible, impossible. We have to have take shelter under the lotus feet of a bona fide spiritual master. How can we take shelter? There are so many so-called masters, one in your find the new girl, who want to tell you what is the real thing. So this is also a question. How we can attain the mercy of our bona fide. It depends on the mercy of the Lord, of Chaitanya. And it depends on the sincerity and the humility of those who are very sincere, develop the desire to understand the truth as it is. Not what they think, what they speculate. We have to follow the process of this, follow since the creation of this universe. Brahma was the creator, and he get this knowledge to the qualified disciple. And it came to Narada Muni, and it came down to the other people. And there are four lines who are still intact, who are one can get this understanding. So we have to by our sincerity, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is sitting in the heart of every living being, he will guide us to one person according to our desire. If we have different motives, if we want to enjoy, if we want to become devotees to enjoy, better enjoy, then you will find a cheater who will make you think this world is meant for enjoyment and I will have to enjoy. If you want to become a servant of the Lord, you have to follow the footsteps of those devotees like Haridas, like Surtamala, like Ramananda, like the six Goswamis, like Vishwanath, and so many great souls who are not from this material world, who come by their own sweet will to this world. So you may think anything, everybody can say this. Everybody can say this, but only the fortunate can realize who is a real devotee and is, a fake devotee. So, devotee is someone who has no self-interest. His only interest is to satisfy his guru and to satisfy Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Mahaprabhu. This is his goal. He doesn't care about anything in this world. In the same way, those who are motherless, do not care for anything what is beyond and after death, what is before, was before. We have to become qualified. It's not our God, it's not our imagination. Krishna, the spirit world, is reality, it is real. But we have not the eye to see now. We are not able to see, because these eyes we have are useless. We cannot see anything beyond matter. But even the mind, whatever the mind is imagining, it is only imagined by me. And when I look to the deities, and I may think, oh, he's smiling to me. When I did something wrong, then maybe he's looking at me like this. But it is my imagination. He do not know. He has no eyes to see. It is only for very beginners. God is reality. God is sitting in the heart of every being. Want to go to his place, you have to develop, you have to follow the process. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Eva Kamalkeva, Kamalasti, 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 Eva, Katya Vyata. In this age of Kali, there is no other way, no other way, no other way, only to change his name of Holy. This is already told before. Long time before Mahaprabhu appeared. It is foretold what are the different processes of understanding, realizing the transcendental world. So, we should trust, we should hear the story of Haridas, this Chaitanya Bhagavata, Chaitanya Charitamrita. We have to go step by step. Don't what is the saying of don't step in where the angel. Don't rush in where the angels fear. Fools rush in where angels fear to treat. So we should be very careful. Because this is a transcendental world, it's not a place that we are ready now to go. So if you want to forcefully, then you may be punished. You may never understand what is the spirit of God. We have to follow the process, we have to follow the proper guide. That's because Krishna sends his masters, spiritual masters. Especially in this Kali Yuga, we are blessed coming in the line of so high qualified Vaishnavas. Who are actually members of the transcendental world. So we are blessed, and we should pray every day for the dust of the lotus feet of such powerful, pure devotees. Not ordinary living beings, you should understand. If you correct, if you make them ordinary living beings and think them of one of, is one of us, then you are lost and you are nowhere. So we should be very careful with these things. This is what is makes a devotee. This is the qualification. Because they move very carefully in this higher sphere and subtle. Because they are not from this world. So if we want to pull them down to our world of sense gratification, of enjoyment, then you may miss the opportunity wherever for a long time to understand the reality. So this is a very important point. Haridas Thakur, there are so many stories. Now we got, after a few weeks, now almost a month or more, we got the second part of Chaitanya Bhagavat. Kept it through the Kimberly only books. We are handling here and waiting. Have you bought some books with you?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. You are very healthy. Everything is okay. So we just came a month ago back from India to be visiting the place of Haridas in Burni, Jagannathpuri. A very special place. The place where Haridas Thakur was chanting his name. I was there first time 1980, something like this, same night or something. There was only the tree, the original tree where Haridas was chanting at the name. It's a Kalpa Viksha tree. Kalpa Viksha means whatever you desire underneath such a tree, it will, this desire will be fulfilled. So there was only a platform of concrete and the tree. Nowadays everything around is temporary and that's very big. I could not recognize that when that comes, they come back. 20 years ago it was already. So one sannyasi, one Indian sannyasi, I very I was fortunate to meet him. He was really devotee. So we gave a group of about 15 devotees. And he is speaking, this is Kalpa Viksha tree, now you desire. whatever you desire will be fulfilled. Then he looked at me. We should only desire Krishna Prem. Krishna Prem. This is if you go to Vrindavan and you are full of desire, and you come out from Vrindavan, you will wonder what will happen. You have deformed desire. You will forget everything. Vrindavan is full of kapha bhiksha trees. You have to be careful in these places. It is not ordinary places. These are places where there are fabricants of the transcendental world. Even you are not able to see. So we are locked in Vrindavan for 1 month or something. So we were forced to stay in that. So we have to change all day. Only in the roof we could go. It's in there. This was not stepping out of the house. So this was a blessing. So gently laying there to hear Harikatha, Chaitanya Bhagavata. Now we can continue this Harikatha in Toya Vik in one part of the missions with Chaitanya Bhagavata. So, if there are no questions, we can chant Hare Krishna, Mama Mata. No. Question?
Thank you.
Sri Guru Nair Ki Jai, Sri Sri Ram Guru.